Hello everyone and welcome back to another video here on Keep Productive. It is Francesco and in today's video I'm going to share with you how I've gone about creating something called a daily log. I wanted to share with you my opinions on using it for a few days at least, about a week or so, and how to actually build it from scratch. The concept's really simple. It's basically using a database template to create this almost get started guide for the morning so that I can start adding and inputting basically like a journal or a daily log in there. Now, before we dive in, a little word from our sponsor. So this video is sponsored by Clean My Mac X. Now, if you're waiting for the impending release of macOS Catalina, then you'll want to be ready and organized. Now, Clean My Mac X is a powerful way to do just that. You can clean up your storage, files, and improve the speed of your CPU using this application. It does a smart scan, allowing you to get a report on all of the things that are slowing down your Mac, and you can get actionable steps on how to improve that just by clicking a few buttons. It's really, really powerful. I've used this application in the past, and it's been very valuable in terms of improving the speed of my Mac. Now, as you can imagine, there are a few things that I particularly like about it. The uninstaller is a fantastic feature. If you want to get rid of some old applications that you no longer use, you can use the batch uninstaller. The same with large files as well. Get rid of those big files that are taking up the massive amount of room, especially when I'm editing. Now, there is also a menu bar, which I really like. If you go up to the top, you can open this menu bar. And what's cool is it will give you like the Mac health. So you can actually see everything from your battery life to the CPU at that current moment in real time. And that's quite a nice little open window so that you can see how your Mac is getting on. Now you can get a license for Clean My Mac for $39.95 for the annual subscription. And you can also get a free trial to test out its powers available in the description below. But I really enjoy using Clean My Mac, so I recommend it highly. And I think you guys really enjoy it too. So a big thank you to Clean My Mac for sponsoring September 2019. So guys, as I said, I wanted to create this daily log with you guys today, show you how to do it from scratch, and we can actually build it with together. It's gonna be quite fun, I think. And it's an opportunity if you're someone that likes to do a little bit of a journal, but wants a bit more of a formalized structure. And the main reason I started it is because I had previously this fitness planner here that is no longer there, that basically was quite useful because it allowed me to add in my thoughts on fitness. But what I wanted to do with this is actually incorporate an entire day log out of it. So I'm going to show you before we move in. It's got a very simple sort of morning area. So this is the morning area, and this is the lunchtime area after, say, some lessons I've learned and also fitness. And then after the day has finished, sort of key takeaways. Now, it's important to see here as well, is this an opportunity to do a bit of journaling, morning checklist, although I haven't really filled this one out yet. Focus on, look at key priorities and also look at the events that I might have for the day. So let's go ahead and start building this from scratch. Let's go to my home. Let's scroll down to this brand new fresh area. So what I started to do was I went ahead and created a sub heading 3, and I called it Daily Logger. Now I added, if you go to color and you go to green background, you've basically got this like just this standout sort of area here that gets started for when you want to add the database below. This is not really necessary. You can add an emoji in front of it, but it just helps it stand out. And then I just simply, when it created, added a divider below it. Now to actually go ahead and create the database, all you have to do is press slash, then type in database. Now, obviously you can do this with a range of different databases. I decided to go with gallery view for the main reason that if I were to click into it, you can see here that it comes up with this quite nice view in terms of seeing what you've actually got in your journal. And what I quite like about it, I started using it on the homepage a little bit more with the reading list, with my goals, because you can start to see the sort of view and it's quite nice. So obviously you can get started pretty easily by deleting the existing cards that they placed inside of here. If I can do that quite easily, there we go. And I'm gonna call this one the log. Just keep the name really simple right now. Now, as you can imagine, when you get started, what you wanna do is go over to the right-hand corner where new is, press new template. Because basically you want to build a template that's going to be replicated multiple amount of times. So I'm going to go ahead and delete created property. I'm going to go ahead and delete tag property. Although, as I said, as I'll say throughout this, you can customize this to however you like. I'm just going to show you how I've done it in the past. So I'm going to go ahead and add date, because that's going to be the day that I normally go ahead and create it. So I'm going to go down to date, format, and time zone. I'm going to go to relative, and I'm going to highlight this one as, so if I click into it, I should be able to type today. And what that should do is every time I open one of these up as a template, it should automatically detect that I'm relating this one to today. So I'm going to get here and type in date. So that's a date. That's just important for when you're coming back to your old logs and looking back at them. The next thing I had was a checkbox into whether I meditated. So I'm going to type in meditate. And that checkbox is really easy because you can tick it off and not tick it off. Then I had one for stretches because I like to go out in the morning and do a few stretches, just some very simple stretches, and having that as a checkbox is really easy. So going back up here, what else did I add? Obviously you can exit that and just come back to the edit tab. So I had one that linked to goal month, although I'll probably get rid of this because it's just a relational database connection. And you can see here that I can connect the month of the goals that this associates to. But it's actually something I learned is pretty pointless. So I won't be including that. And also I had this focus area where I just had like the thing I wanted to focus on. Previously, obviously, you can see it was a lot to do with my workouts. So I've got cardio core. So you could have, let's just include it down here. So if I go back up here and go to edit on this one that we started. If I go to here and maybe put focus and choose the multi-select. So maybe you can add your focus for the day. So there we go. Maybe you want to drag that one up. So that's your sort of basic properties to get started. Maybe you want to add an icon for every time you create a new one of these. Maybe you want a fire icon with new log so that you give your area a title. And maybe you want to add a cover photo as well. It's totally up to you in this case. Let's remove it. So down here is where all of the magic happens. Now, you can create this whatever sort of situation you like. You might want to make a sort of timeline view like I have, like a morning one, an afternoon one, and an evening one, a way for you to sort of log what's happened in a day. But I'm going to start by typing in, what did I type in to get started? I think I type in quote, and I put 7 a.m. morning, because that's typically when I wake up, and I added a divider below it. Now you can design this whatever you like, but I tend to add colors in there because it sort of makes it a bit brighter. And I also put this in bold. So that's just a simple control B to bold that. Now you might want different areas. And the way that I did this is just to make a little bit of space down here and go ahead and create a subheading too. And maybe I want to start with that journal entry. So of course I might want to add more. So I'm going to say as well in here, I also want a checklist for the morning like I had before. And I will also show the events on today. And let's create another subheading of finally priorities. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm going to put the checklist over here. And that's a simple way to break things up. Probably the Notion is who regulars will know how to do this pretty well. So I'm going to give a little bit of space between them. So I've got sort of four quadrants. And the reason I got this idea sort of structurally is actually from an application called Grid Diary, which is something that actually does this if you don't want to use Notion. But I find it actually a really nice experience. Now, what I actually did is I gave all of these different colors. So I will go ahead and just add a few different colors because it just brightens up the area a bit more and it makes it more interactive 100%. Now, if I go below here, I can add a divider. I'm just going to go ahead and copy and paste this divider. Drag it to the different underneath here into the different areas. So I've got four dividers equally spread out there. So the one thing I did differently is I used a call out, which is a relatively new feature, to explain what these mean. So that it's almost like a bit of a dummy's guide. So for example, add five lines of how I'm feeling. And maybe I want to go ahead and change that icon to a book like I did before. And the same with this, you can do this really easily. Like you can change this to a checklist, things to do in the morning. And vice versa, like if I was down here, I could say call out, and that hasn't connected up. Things I must do, and maybe like be a bit more aggressive with it, put a fire flame, and I could just drag this below here. And if I wanted to just be a little bit faster, I could copy and paste that and drag that here. So maybe I want to say events, what's on today? What's on today? So I can then, what I'm pretty happy with now is that I've got an area for my journal entry. Maybe I want to add some bullet points to get me started on what's happened and maybe give myself a little bit of space. So that's how to do that. And if you wanted to check boxes, for example, like you could start adding stuff so it's a bit easier for you, like meditate, don't snooze alarm. See, this isn't anything like magical. It's just a very simple checklist. And you could say, make cup of tea. And if you were really playing around, you could add a little bit of color to this. And the great thing about this, guys, is if you do it once, you've then got the ability to just go and create like a new one every single time. So you can always go in here at the end of the month and go, actually, I'm going to sort this out a little bit and make this a little bit neater. Now, I'm actually seeing up here that I probably want this one to be a bit bigger, maybe a heading one, so it's quite clear. And I could always add emoji to the front here to make it a little bit more interactive. So if I go down here, I might want to add some like to-dos, maybe some space for some to-dos. So I'm just going to add one in this case, because maybe that's the one thing I need to do. And this is how I actually went about organizing the... So I actually have an events calendar over here, events and activities, which gives me a bit of an outline of the events I've got coming up, or at least the major stuff. And I actually can view this as a calendar as well. I don't know why that's not coming up. I normally have it as a view as a calendar. Maybe I changed it. Sometimes I... Ah, here we go. Upcoming events. Okay, so I've got two calendars. That's got a filter on it. That's why it was not properly showing up. But if I've got upcoming events, I can see like all of the upcoming events I've got in September. So what I'll do is very simply say, go back to where we were, is I'll go into this database template and I will create a linked database. Now, what am I going to create it on? I'm going to go and create it on upcoming events. And obviously, it's going to pull in all of the events I've ever had. And you don't want that. You only want the today ones. So it's really quite simple to do that. If you were to actually get a little bit more space, you might want to drag this in a bit of a more of an open area, like here, so that you get that full width. And you can go ahead and go to filter. Then you go to add filter. Date is today. And there you go. You've got a bit of a view of what you've actually gone on today. In this case, I actually don't have anything. But then you can drag it underneath there. So that's a really useful sort of database to have, because you can then see any activities you've got, open them up, and get started writing them. Now, as you can imagine, I don't necessarily want to show you the full area. Let me show you what I've got as my daily log. I'll show you. So as you can see, it's pretty simple. I've added like this call out at the top saying, "Rise and shine, Francesco." And I've got one under here, which is called the 12 p.m. lunch. We've got the fitness sort of checklist, some lessons I've learned maybe, and also focuses for tomorrow. Now, I'm going to be honest with you guys. I haven't used this to the full. I have been really bad with that, I'd say. But I am looking to like force myself to use it more. But I have been using the start of the day a lot. So that actually has helped me to sort of have a morning meeting with myself to see what videos I need to create, etc. So that's one of the things I found valuable. Now, you're probably wondering, how do you make it sort of start and disappear? So at the end of the day, what I actually want it to do is for this actual entry to disappear. So you may have seen there's no entry that was created today. If I go over here, I've created a filter inside of this linked database to date is today. And basically, it will only show the ones that have a date associated, the property to today. So how to do that inside of here, let's say I go ahead and I go, okay, I want to create a new log. There we go. There's my entry. Saves me a huge amount of time. And all I have to do is go to filter to the date is today. And if I, for example, wanted to see all of my history of it, all I'd have to do is go to filter and press X. And you should see all of the other entries from the previous days come in. And these were my last ones. These were my sort of workouts and the sort of workout log, and I actually found it really valuable. So I've started to do it there. And what's quite nice is if you don't want people to see like inside here, you can, because it doesn't actually bring in text underneath callouts. So if you're like really cautious or you don't want anybody to see your data, then you can. So if I go to date is today, it should bring it up. So that's how to go ahead and create a very simple organization area. So the one thing I'm going to do to finalize things is change that to list. I quite like that list view. And that's how to go ahead and create a sort of daily life tab. I hope this video was useful, guys. My recommendation as well is to check out the Notion Made Simple course if you're looking to learn everything from scratch. We're working on some really exciting updates for it. And of course, it's a forever course, so you'll continue to learn and grow with Notion. So guys, a big, big thank you. Please do let me know in the comments if you have any questions. You know my email. It's normally in the comments or description below. And I'll talk to you guys very, very soon. Please do check out the other videos after this in the end card. So if you want to go enjoy more Notion videos or more Evernote videos or more to-do's videos, there's probably plenty of them. Anyway, guys, a big thank you, and I'll talk to you guys very soon. Cheers, everyone.